Una vita che ha definito il ruolo della monarchia britannica. Con Filippo d'Edimburgo se ne va davvero un'epoca, insieme all'uomo che i suoi nipoti definiscono una leggenda. Lo descrive in questa intervista uno dei massimi esperti reali, Phil Dampier, giornalista già corrispondente per il quotidiano The Sun.
For 65 years, he was at her side, or often several paces behind her, and he made that his life's work to look after her and support her. And she would be the first person to say, I think, that without his support, she couldn't have had this extraordinary long reign. Well, of course, people forget that they are actually related. They are actually third cousins, directly descended from Queen Victoria. So they did bump into each other at family weddings. And when the Queen was actually eight, she first saw Prince Philip when he was 13, of course, 5 years older than her. And then, of course, they met again when she went to the Dartmouth Naval College with her parents. And he looked after her for the day, and the romance went on from there. And people say that it was very much a case of, for her, of love at first sight. He was all over the place. He had a very peripatetic childhood and moved around a lot. And I think that gave him an inner strength, which stood him in good stead for the rest of his life. But he didn't see a lot of his parents in his childhood and was brought up by a variety of relatives. And I think that really molded him and made him very self-dependent and independent. He was rather notorious for the gaffes that he made. They were called gaffes, but I think most of them he was just trying to put people at their ease and break the ice. And sometimes people are very nervous when they meet members of the royal family. So he tried to make people laugh, and sometimes it came off and sometimes it didn't. And sometimes some people were insulted by what he said, but most of the time I don't think he meant to offend anyone. But on his own, certainly the Duke of Edinburgh Award Scheme, that was attended by millions of people throughout the world. His work for the World Wildlife Fund, which became the World Wildlife Fund for Nature, and highlighting the problems of overpopulation and the environment.